What's going on, guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Apollo Jake and I'm a music producer from the Bay Area, California. I'm 19 years old and this is the platform I use to go through mixing sessions, product reviews, and even some of my own personal music as well. Thank you for joining me here today. As you can tell from the title, we're reworking one of my old songs. I wrote this song about 4 years ago and I just thought it'd be nice to kind of reproduce it using my knowledge today about like how to make music and how to make it sound a little more pleasing to the ear. It's in drop D, while my guitar is tuned to drop A, so we're gonna be using pitch shifting. But that being said, I'm gonna have to record it in drop A and then pitch shift it up to drop D later. Why pitch shift it up? Just to retain the original. We'll see what happens. I'm kind of just gonna have fun with this. Anyways, if you're new here, make sure to stick around. I post videos every Saturday, as well as I post on Instagram and TikTok, and I even post shorts here on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching, and let's just get right into it. Okay, so the original riff itself is kind of like this like 195-ish BPM, I don't remember, and it's like a 12, 13 riff. I was really into that, like 12, 13, 0 riffs. I'll show you what it sounds like in drop A, and then we'll record a scratch take, and then we'll draw for the drums, and then we'll do the bass afterwards as well. So that's what it sounds like in drop A. We have a visitor back here. Welcome to the camera. And so I'll record a scratch take. We'll pitch it up to drop a D later on. And then, yeah. Okay, that's good enough for a scratch take. It doesn't really matter. I think my input set a little high there, so my gain is pretty loud there on the guitar track. But again, scratch take, doesn't really matter. So where's the... Okay. Cool, so it's like 8 bars. Not to worry. I mean, it's super messy, but it really doesn't matter. Let's track some drums now. Let's see. We got drums here. Whoa, my microphone is about to fall. There we go. Cool. So we'll just track some drums. And then I also want to throw in some more here, kind of like syncopation on this like triple, you know, like dotted rhythm here. I don't actually know if it's right, but I'm hoping it is. Cool, and then the crash cymbals now. Yeah, I kind of switched it up. I wanted to do like this, I don't know. I wanted to do this really like halftime rhythm. It used to kind of be like that too, actually. Yeah, that's not realistic. The bell and the china at the same time, as well as the other crash, not gonna happen. Okay. And I think here, actually, I think I'm actually kind of digging the snare drum doing dotted rhythms and then the... Like, that's kind of cool. This little polyrhythmic dotted rhythmy thingy. So that's that. That's the main rhythm, you know? But the riff actually like starts with just toms and just like this really build-up-y kind of thing. You know, so we'll just track in kicks really quickly. And then we'll just track in some toms as well. Probably this one. No. Yeah. It's interesting how when it records with zero feedback, of zero latency, and then when you listen back to it, it has latency in the recording. Okay, so this should be about that long, and we're just gonna repeat that, and we'll just join all of those together. Also, the first rhythm of these should probably be on the crash. Just probably for fun, you know? And then I have some post-production stuff in here already. Just I always load up these. It's really cool. This is just a stock Logic little sample they have there. And yeah, it sounds pretty good. Yeah, cool. Okay, so let's record bass. Let's record bass right now. Why am I getting distorted guitar? Ah, there we go. That's why, because I had that on. I was like, what the heck is the bass? But yeah, remember the bass is kind of gonna be it's wonky. I've already gone over this in several previous videos. Basically, when it records, it doesn't shift it down an octave. I am just using my guitar because I don't have a bass on me. I'm traveling the world right now. If you'll notice from the previous video, I'm now in a different place. I'm in the south of France, not Spain. So we're just constantly moving around, bringing music with us. Cool, so that's good enough for bass. I mean, it's not really much I can do other than just like, I don't know. And it was 16th notes, right? So let's just have a quick little listen back. Nice, yeah. Okay, so that's bass tracked in there. That should be good. Should be good for bass. Okay, so there's that. And then we need to record actual guitar takes here. And so I'm gonna just quickly do that in stereo. Again, I'm sorry, I haven't figured out how to get my audio from my computer to you guys in stereo. So you're gonna have to wait for the stereo playback like at the end of the video, like usual. I'm really sorry. I don't know what to do about it, but we'll see what we can do. I just went ahead and did double the length, and so that I can just, you know, bring this in. So now we have a stereo playback. Again, for you, it's not going to be stereo. I'm sorry. And then I definitely remembered that at the start, I had this like... Yeah, I had just one in the left ear, which is interesting. I don't know why, but that's what I did. So I'm going to redo that again because I thought that was kind of cool. We are going to run some lead guitars now. These can just get turned right the way down. They do not need to be loud at all. And then it was just these just repeated on the old drums there, you know. And same thing again for this. It's repeated again. Okay, I'm having a problem. I think the guitar should just be open instead of me trying to like palm mute it. It's just not really working. I don't know. I used to have it like that, but I don't think I need to really do that like that anymore. So. Good enough for that take. I'm sorry that my computer is actually like heck of lagging right now. I don't know why that is. I got my buffer size set typically. Don't know what that's about, but it's just like, it's just struggling, man, with all the recording software going and everything. It's just like, oh, help me. Again, I'm going to redo the bass so that the bass is now matching. Then, so that's that section, really. That's like kind of the intro, which is kind of cool. And from there, it goes on to like a bunch of verses and stuff, which we can get into as well. Yeah, I mean, I think the verse is super simple, and there's a chorus as well. I don't remember the chord progression, but now we're just gonna play around with the pitch shifting because I want to now pitch shift this up, essentially. So I think my idea is going to be to take a break from recording guitars, and I'm going to try and throw in some synthesizers and bass and just like in the background, in the behind, just kind of like try and support it a little bit, you know, like get a siren that matches the, you know, the siren of the guitars, get like a synth that matches the bass and guitar line and really like add some depth to it. So I think that's what I'm going to take a break and do right now. So I'm going to punch that stuff in, probably just going to throw this on a time lapse because it's just going to be a long process of me just, you know, just punching things in. So yeah, probably gonna catch you after I work on that, and I'll show you what I come up with then. Okay, that being said, I think that's probably gonna cut it with this riff. I wanted to make a much longer video, but I didn't really have time. It's kind of pitch black where I am. We had a long work day. I'm a little bit knackered. I need to get to bed. I think I'm happy with this riff for just being a little mock-up. It's just kind of like something I wrote a long time ago. I just wanted to freshen up. So let's have a little listen, I guess, to what we came up. I'm sorry that this video was probably a little bit shorter than last week's video. I didn't have enough time. I'm sorry about that. But, let's have a listen. I mean, that being said, for a super quick session, I'm happy with how it came out. I think if I was to revisit this riff, I'd really want to just kind of like make it heavier and make it more produced. Like when I do these videos, I'm using a basic template that I've created. It's just kind of like a one beat all template to just like make something that sounds okay. If I really want to produce it, I will actually throw it to a different file and properly produce the song. But these shorter videos, I kind of just use a basic template of like some things I've used in the past. Definitely would want to make it sound bigger, would want to make it a little bit louder, probably hit a little harder. I don't know what the loudness was hitting. I wasn't recording. It says negative 12. Yeah, it's quite quiet actually, for like a metal track. I don't know. Anyways, I think that's gonna do it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Sorry this one was shorter. I'll catch you next Saturday and potentially in the middle of the week with a product review. Thank you guys so much. I'll see you later. Peace.